This video will teach you all the tricks I know, so that you can code as fast as me. I've got shortcuts, tips and tricks split into basics, code navigation and code writing. And I use each and every one of them every day, so don't skip any, because I won't show you boring things like press F10 to step over, but new useful things. As a programmer, you spend 99% of your time in Visual Studio, so the best thing to do is to learn to use it more efficiently. Nothing pains me more than seeing a beginner move so slowly, so let's fix that today. Let's start with making the coding area bigger. The more you see, the better. So, move the Solution Explorer to the right and press the Auto Hide button. This will keep it hidden. And after you use it, you can just click back to your code and it will disappear. And if you are wondering why I put it on the right, it's because on the left, it would cover our coding area. Next, I put my output and my error list on the bottom. And I press this again. So, whenever you compile, you will see the messages, but once you click back on your code, it will disappear. Finally, I have my taskbar on auto-hide to always have things full screen. If you don't like this, at least make it smaller. Or you can press Shift-Alt-Enter to make Visual Studio full screen. You might ask now, but how can I navigate between files with no Solution Explorer? Don't worry, you'll also learn that. But let's move into shortcuts. First of all, I'm tired of seeing beginners click this button that opens the program with the debugger. Just press Ctrl plus F5. You don't want your debugger to open every time. But if you want it, you can press F5. Also, if you press F11, the program will start in debug mode and break automatically at the main function. This can be quite useful for finding the main function. And this leads us to navigating your code more efficiently. If you have a big project, you will often want to go to a specific file or even a specific place. But it's very hard to find. So let's look at a specific example. I'm editing some code here, and suddenly I want to change the definition of this struct. In order to very quickly find the definition of something, you can just press F12 on it, or Ctrl click it. So, this got me to the definition of the variable. Ctrl click again on the type, and now I'm inside the class. I want to edit this method, maybe, so I can Ctrl click it. All good, but now I want to go back to where I was in the beginning. No problem. I can just press the back button on the mouse, or Ctrl minus. This is probably the most useful shortcut, and it will get you back to where you were before. And just press that until you get to where you want to go. Also, to go forward, you can press the forward mouse button, or Ctrl Shift minus. But I'm not done yet. If you are inside the CPV file, you can press Ctrl K, Ctrl O to navigate to its corresponding header file and back. Isn't that awesome? You can also Ctrl click a header file, or F12, or Ctrl Shift G to go inside it. And speaking of the G key, Ctrl G will get you to any line that you want. But this is the most powerful tool to search files and things. So you probably know about Ctrl F to find something. I use it quite often, but there's an even more powerful feature. Comma Ctrl will open this dialog for you. Here you can search for files or struct definitions or functions. I usually use it to quickly find the file. So, by now you should be an expert in navigating around the files. But let's also look at code writing now. So first of all, you should learn to use the arrows to move around the code instead of using your mouse, because that's much faster. So if you want to move an entire word, you can do Ctrl arrows. And to select a word, you can hold Shift. So, to select an entire word, you can Ctrl Shift arrows. And you might also have the home and end keys. And they get you to the beginning or the end of the current line. You can even do Shift home to select everything on the left or Shift end. Now, I hope you know about Ctrl X to cut, Ctrl C to copy and Ctrl V to paste. But did you know that if you don't have anything selected, it will copy or cut the entire current line? This can be useful, because by pressing Ctrl X, you can cut an entire line, and then you can easily paste it wherever you want. Or if you want to duplicate a line, just press Ctrl C and Ctrl V. No need to select it. And you can even be in the middle of it, and it still works. But this is probably the coolest feature. You can edit multiple lines at the same time. So, in order to write to multiple lines, you can either press Shift-Alt and select or click with your mouse on the desired area that you want. This can be useful to easily delete things, or you can press Shift-Alt and then the down or up arrow keys to create multiple lines, and you can type and delete stuff. But here is the coolest thing. All the other shortcuts I showed you work here. So let's say you select these lines, then you can press Home to go to the beginning. Now all the words have different sizes, but you can use Ctrl arrows to navigate one word at a time. And now I can go ahead and edit this. And finally, I will go a few more words to add the semicolon. and I have some bonuses for you. So first of all, I use this extension to highlight me all the occurrences of the current selected word. This is extremely useful, because I can easily see where that thing is used in a file or if it exists somewhere else in that file. And also I use this extension, and I configured it to press Alt Space to open the command prompt. It is useful for Git stuff, or you can also press Ctrl Q to open the feature search. And here, you can just search for any features of Visual Studio, like opening the command prompt. And I have one more, but you should try all of these shortcuts yourself to learn them. And maybe save this video to refresh your memory later. Okay, so if you press Windows V, this will bring up the clipboard. So all the things that you copied previously will be stored here. And if you want more tricks like this related to Windows development, like this zoom feature or various useful tools and tricks, I'm working on a video on that. So go click the first link in the description to see if it is available. See you there.